गुड नून टू एवरी वन. टुडे डिस्कस अबाउट द इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन प्रोसेस कंट्रोल. ओके आईपीसी यूनिट नंबर 10 कंट्रोलर ट्यूनिंग एंड एडवांस कंट्रोलर. ओके एंड द यूनिट नंबर 12 13 14 एंड 15 जी मेजरमेंट पार्ट है ते ऑलरेडी अपने तमने ग्रुप ऑफ मटेरियल मोकली आपू है. उसे टेम्परेचर मेजरमेंट, प्रेशर मेजरमेंट, लिक्विड लेवल मेजरमेंट, फ्लो मेजरमेंट. ओके एने आपणे नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में डिस्कशन करीशुं डिटेल में. नाउ दी पार्ट ऑफ द यूनिट नंबर 10 कंट्रोलर ट्यूनिंग एंड एडवांस कंट्रोलर फॉर ज़िग्लर निकोल्स मेथड. ओके दिस इज इम्पोर्टंट इन जीटीयू एग्जाम. नाउ द स्टार्ट कंसिडर द सिलेक्शन ऑफ अ कंट्रोलर जीसी फॉर द जनरल कंट्रोल सिस्टम ऑफ फिगर 17.5. वी फर्स्ट प्लॉट द बॉड डायग्राम जे आपणे ऑलरेडी डिस्कस करी गया छे. ओके फॉर द फाइनल कंट्रोल एलिमेंट्स द प्रोसेस एंड द मेजरिंग एलिमेंट इन द सीरीज G1, G2, H एंड जी ओमेगा इट शुड बी एम्फसाइज्ड दैट द कंट्रोलर इज ओमिटेड फ्रॉम दिस प्लॉट. सपोज द डायग्राम अपीयर्स इज इन फिगर 17.6 एज नोटेड ऑन द फिगर. The crossover frequencies for the these three components in a sense is a omega C0. At the crossover frequency, the overall gain is capital A as indicated according to be the Baud criterion. Then the gain of a proportional controller which would cause the system of the figure 17.5 to be on the verge of instability is a 1 by A. We define this quantity to be the ultimate gain capital K. Thus, which is the equation KU is equal to 1 by A. And aapde follow karvanu chhe. Okay, again repeated for a Ziegler-Nichols controller setting. Consider selection of a controller GC for the general control system of figure 17.5. We first plot the Baud diagram for the final control element, the process and we measuring element in a series G1, G2 and H, G omega. It should be emphasized that the controller is omitted from this plot. Suppose the diagram appears as in a figure 17.6. As noted on this figure, the crossover frequencies for these three components in a sense is omega C0. At the crossover frequency, the overall gain is A, as indicated according to the Baud criterion. Then the gain of a proportional controller which would cause the system of figure 17.5 to be the on the verge of instability is a 1 by A. We will define this quantity to be the ultimate gain capital K. Thus the KU is equal to 1 by A. Simple. Okay. Thus KU is equal to 1 by A. The ultimate period PU is defined the period of the sustained cycling that would be the occurs if a proportional controller with a gain KU where we used from the discussion of in figure 7.3 already. We know this to be the part of PU is equal to 2 pi by omega C0 time per cycle. Okay, by equations yaad rakhvana chhe tamare. This one. The ultimate period PU is defined as the period of the sustained cycle that would occur if a proportional controller with gain KU, where we used from the discussion of a figure. This one. Now, the PU is equal to 2 pi by omega C0 time per cycle. Write down this equation. Now the discussion part is this factor. Simply, this is the final equations 2. Now that the factors of 2 pi appears, so that pu will be in a unit of time per cycle rather than in a time per radian. It should be emphasized that ku and pu are easily determined from the board diagram figure 17.6. The Ziegler-Nichols setting for a controller part are determined directly from KU and PU according to the rules summarized in this table. Unfortunately, the specifications of KC and TD for PD control cannot be made using only KU and P. In general, the values of 0.6 KU and rho U by 8, which correspond to the limiting case of no integral actions in a three mode controller, are too conservative. This is the Ziegler-Nichols controller setting part. This is the completely types of controller. Ziegler-Nichols controller setting, the types of the control: proportional control system, proportional integral control system, proportional integral derivative control system, PPID, PI, GC of S, KC, TI and TD. No, J basis chat is system at a proposal matic KC and a 0.5 KU, PI matic KC in a bracket 1 plus 1 upon tau 1 S, 0.45 KU. The PU by 1.2, the proportional integral derivative, the KC under bracket 1 plus 1 by T1S plus TDS, the 0.6 KU, PU by 2 and a PU by 8. Now the resulting system will be two stables. There exists a method for this case which are in a principle no more difficult to use than the Ziegler-Nichols rules. Yeah, one of those in the selection of TD for a maximum KC at a 30 degree phase margin, which was discussed above. Another method which utilizes the step response and avoids trial and error is presented in this unit 19. The reasoning behind the Ziegler-Nichols selection of values of KC is relatively clear. In the case of proportional control, only a gain margin of 2 is established. The addition of integral actions introduce more phase, like at all these frequencies, hence a lower value of KC is required to maintain roughly the same gain margin. Adding derivative actions introduce phase lead, hence more gain may be tolerated. This is was the demonstrated, for example, 7.2 part. However, by and large, the Ziegler-Nichols setting are based on the experience with the typical processes and should be regarded as first estimate. Okay. Now, again, repeat. Now, the example is first of all this one. Then the 17.3 example, using the Ziegler-Nichols rules, determine Kc and Ti for the control system shown in the figure 17.10. For this problem, the computations will be done without plotting a board diagram. The however the reader may wish to do the problem with such as a diagram, we first obtain the crossover frequency by applying the board stability criterion. For a minus 180 degree is equal to minus 10 inverse 0 minus 57.3 in the bracket 1.02 omega. The values 57.3 converts radians to degree. Solving these equations by trial and error gives for the crossover frequencies omega c 0 is equal to 2 radian per minute. The amplitude ratio at the crossover frequency for the open loop can be written. For amplitude ratio is equal to 1 by kc in under root 1 plus omega square. No, 1 is equal to kc by 2.24, where we have used the equation 16.16 for the first order system, and the fact that the amplitude ratio for a transport leg is 1 according to the border criterion. The amplitude ratio is 1.0 at the crossover frequencies when the system is on the verge of instability in stirring AR. In the above equations, and solving for KC gives the KCU is equal to 2.24, and the KC is equal to 0.45. KCU is equal to, in a bracket mein multiply karso, 0.45 multiply 2.24, the answer also 1.01. and the TI is equal to PU by 8, it is PU by 1.2, is equal to in bracket 2 pi by omega c 0 by 1.2, is equal to answer also 2.62 minute. Aaj a board diagram che, a block diagram draw kar lo, block diagram for the example 17.3. This one block diagram, above diagram draw thai gyo. You simply kc in a bracket 1 plus 1 by tau 1 s 1 upon s plus 1 and e raised to minus 1.2 s. for a amplitude ratio mate jovanu chhe apne. Okay, for using example 17.4, yeah, but I just saw next lecture. And next one theory is transience response. The Ziegler approach. ઓકે મેન આપણે ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ જોવાનું છે ધ પ્રોસેસ એપ્લિકેશન્સ. ओके, रेशियो कंट्रोल, स्मिथ प्रेडिक्टर, प्रोसेस कंट्रोल में जीशू अपने एडवांस कंट्रोल स्ट्रेटजीज ना मन थी. कैस्केड कंट्रोल छे, देन सम ब्लॉक डायग्राम एनालिसिस कैस्केड कंट्रोल આપણે એનાલિસિસ કેસ્કેડ કંટ્રોલ જોવાના છે નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચરમાં. એન્ડ જનરલાઇઝેશન્સ નથી, ડિજિટલ કંટ્રોલ બી છે એ જોઈશું આપણે. નાઉ ધીસ પાર્ટ ફોર ફીડ ફોરવર્ડ કંટ્રોલ બી છે એ જોઈશું આપણે. ઓકે, ધીસ ઇઝ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ થિયરી. થેન્ક યુ સો મચ.